Hello, I'm Wafflestick, and welcome back to my Minecraft Survival Series here on the WayStone server. We are currently on Season 2, Episode 13, and I have some pretty big plans today. I need to get this done very fast, or get it done this episode, most definitely. And I kick myself every time I think of it. We need iron. We need iron to do redstone projects and things like that. But I'm over here by my modern home, and I'm trying to think if there's a way to integrate that into my modern house home. The only thing is, zombies. I don't want hordes, like, invade my home. That'd be kind of awkward. But, yes, I want to try to work on an iron farm today because I feel like it needs to be done, or it's never going to get done. But if you didn't see the live stream that we had done yesterday, or was it today? No, yesterday. I had worked on the structure of the home, and I think most of it is complete if we take a look at it. It's a very simple design as of right now. I'm not really sure what else could go into this design. Maybe even blocking that up with some white concrete real quick would maybe make it look a little bit better. Can we parkour onto that block? Yeah, we can. Sweet. Let's go ahead and place in a strut of concrete there to see if that looks a little bit better before we do get started with everything. Okay. Nice. So I want to go ahead and see if I can gather some build materials, put this stuff away, and we're going to start on that iron farm because we need it. We need it now. So I'm at that point where I'm wondering, do we actually build one away from the modern home or within the design of it? And as much as I would love to do a design within it, I think it'd be better for us to just go ahead and do a standalone one because I don't really want a zombie siege taking everything out over in my area. So hopefully this double chest of stuff is still down here. I'm not really sure if anyone's been down here, but from the looks of it, I think everything's still down here. It's quite a ways. There we go. Go ahead and dig down a bit and see what we've got. We do have a bunch of the stone because we had to use silk touch. I must say that is a lot of stone. Wow. And I'm not really sure what kind of design I want to go with. I think I'm just going to go with a very standard design like I had done with the other iron farm in season one. But that's really all there is to it. I think maybe grabbing some of these would be a good thing because I am always needing cobblestone. Well, time to build back up and get to work on this. We also have to get a bunch of wood as well. We're back over here at base, and I think there is a village very close. If we were to just go ahead and fly here, I think there's really a village just across these trees. Yes, there is. So this is going to be relatively easy to get the villagers back. Let's see what kind of villagers we have in this village, because I haven't really taken a look. And I don't want to steal them all. I know the Olympic Dream had looked at this village, and he really liked it. We do have some trading villagers here, which I don't know if it's necessary, but you do need some villagers that will trade to have them to repopulate and, well, you know, repopulate, and they will go ahead and start spawning in iron golems. It takes, I think, 10 villagers to do it. So we know that's there. It's pretty much a straight path from our modern home. We are relatively pretty close to Olympic Dream, oddly enough. I want to try to be a little bit careful about spoilers now that I am pretty close to this area. Oh, I'm loving this modern home. The more I look at it, the more I'm liking it. But I'm still trying to decide where would be the best place to put this iron farm. I'm thinking... I was thinking maybe here in the front, but that would just kind of, you know, destroy the view of the home back here, which I wouldn't like particularly well. And I don't want it to be super close to my base, but at the same time, maybe it would be better if it was close, because we want it to be active. I stay in my base quite a bit whenever I'm not recording to do some AFK stuff. So I'm thinking maybe somewhere back here would be good, but it's very weird to work with. I have a feeling that it'd be a good thing to bring my beacon over, do some terraforming before we do anything. Oh, it's... Yeah, I think that would be the best thing to do. I'm going to head back over to the base then and grab my beacon, go ahead and terraform this. And I'm going to try my best to do a third-person time-lapse, which I don't think it's going to happen because I don't have Optifine. But I think I may be able to figure something out. So I really couldn't get the time lapse working, unfortunately. I'm really upset at me. I really wanted to do a time lapse, but I have finished terraforming the area, and I think it looks a lot better than what it did, because we have a lot of project space now. We can go around our base building anything that we want to, and that's the lovely part about it. We have all this open and clean space, and I think negative space really complements modern builds. Whenever you have a bunch of this negative space, that emphasizes all the positive space, and it just looks good as a modern build. We have all these very different colors out here. A lot of emphasis on this building for sure. But I had started thinking, if I am going to be building my iron farm back here, I think I want to do something similar to the build behind me. Do a modern build, but keep it as its separate own thing, not really integrate it into the design of the house. I think that's going to look a lot better, because we don't have to worry about zombie hordes and zombie sieges happening and being all in our house. But there's a lot more space to work out here with, and it's a really great thing, because I was feeling slightly claustrophobic from being so close to the trees and such. And it seems my home has been taken over by skeletons. But that is the plan, if we just go up here to just take a look real quick. That's looking pretty good. I like all the space that we can really fill in with some good stuff. But I'm going to go back in my FK hole and sit here and try to think of a good design for that mob farm. I have found a place for my iron farm, but Frimp has been building something at spawn that we need to go look at. And in the meantime, while he was building that last night, I went ahead and decided to go ahead and start building a little bit more on our base. We now have a terracotta masterpiece in the wall, which looks pretty good. I like that pattern. I was going to put some other blocks in there, but I just think it looks a little bit better with one single pattern. But yes, Frimp has done something at spawn that we need to be aware of. So I'm just going to go over and take a look. Because he said to wait until he was done before you come over to spawn, so that might be something we need to take in consideration. Something like a prank, maybe. Who knows? Oh, there's a new structure right there. Okay. I noticed that there's like a little gray splotch here. So this is, I guess, what he has done. Looks like a community mine shaft. Let's go in here and see what we got. Okay, so ends right here. Awfully suspicious. Redstone torches. Wafflestick. The Olympic dream. Okay, we'll go this way, Frimp. Let's see what's going on. Oh, okay. Did you leave a friend in here for me? I just swiped out that redstone torch. There we go. We needed some more of that anyway. Let's go ahead and place this back here. 50% off boots. Frimp, you are amazing. I am, even just these. Oh, and the gold blocks. I mean, that's amazing. 50% off. So in this chest, it looks like we've got a bunch of inner pearls. I'm going to just go ahead and take a stack of these. And we have a Waystone Olympic book here. Let's go ahead and take a look and see what this says. Waffle, you have been invited to join the Waystone Olympics. In these Olympics, you will be competing against none other than the Olympic Dream. These series of events will test your skill and knowledge of Minecraft. Now you may know a lot about retailing, thanks for 50% off. But this is more than running a pawn shop. Check back here every now and then for further instructions. Take this book from here. So the Olympic Master Frimp knows you have read it. So looks like you have some stuff planned for us, Frimp. I am pretty excited. I want to compete in some kind of Olympic. That seems to be my style of thing. Wow. Thanks, Frimp. I'm just going to go ahead and take your book then. I will put it in a safe place. I'm excited. So it looks like the Olympic Dream has got to explore his, which maybe sometime soon, maybe sometime later. We're not sure yet. But I'm just going to go ahead and go back over to my area, keep this, and watch for the Olympics to come about, because I want to do some contests. That sounds fun. So you remember, whenever I was saying I wasn't going to build it, a part of my house, well, that has changed. I have decided to put it on top of my house, and this is what I've got. So even if I did want to switch it up, it's going to be a very big hassle to get everything removed. but I have a pretty nice water system here. I worked around with it a bit, and we have a bigger spawner so that we can get more iron. Now, the only drawback about this is we're going to have to do some multiple pockets with the villagers, but I think that's going to be probably the most difficult part, because putting the doors in is going to be fine. We're just going to, you know, roam like we usually do, and I think I may actually put some glass blocks on top of those doors so that way mobs cannot spawn on top of the edges here. But yeah, this is the design I want to go with. I think this is going to be good. It's like a medium iron production, so it's a little bit bigger than season one, and we don't have to worry about iron. I think that is going to work. I've just got a bunch of stuff like stored in here. Of course, we do still have a little bit of work to do with it. I was really hoping I wasn't going to fall in here. I wonder if I got a elytra out here. Can I do it? Can I? Nope. Do I have to? Okay, let's just jump forward and see. Okay, that's not going to work. This has created an unintentional mob spawner, though, so that's kind of concerning. We got creepers, we got skeletons. Oh, there's another skeleton. Okay. So yeah, it's a little bit dark in there, and I want to change up the blocks. I want to go with a modern outer layer so that just looks a little bit more seamless with my house, and it'll look like an extra layer that's stacked. The only thing is this wall is flat, so I may actually have to take that wall out and put in concrete. So on this outer edge, which that shouldn't be too much, that should be pretty easy. And then if we do the outer layers on the other side, that should all come together quite nicely. But let's go ahead and get to work on those doors and trying to get another portal set up for the village. And I'll catch you guys up. After a little bit of networking, we do have another portal going to the village, which is excellent. Let me just show you how easy this is going to be. You remember in season one, whenever the tunnel was a little bit long and it wasn't particularly good? Well, this is the portal to the village. And literally, just a few blocks up here, this is the portal to my base. So this is right outside of... Pig, what are you doing in here? This isn't a place for pigs. But yes, we do have this portal to my base, and we also have this portal to the village. So it's going to be that simple. I just craft up a bunch of boats, and I've got to make a temporary track to get everything started. Whoa, that is, there's something totally wrong with this. How do you like my little box in the nether? And you can actually see through and see things on the other side. So if we were to keep going, maybe that's a snapshot bug. We'll remember that one, because I need to probably submit that to the Minecraft forums. Can it do it this way? No, it's just whenever you're on a certain block before the nether portal. Okay. I'll have to remember that. That's kind of wild. Let me go ahead and see if I can get the boats going, and then we will go ahead and try to get the villagers in pockets on top of the spawner itself. So I believe this is the last villager. I've got a bunch of them over here. And it's relatively easy. I had actually messed up on the portals, but it's a good thing. So the thing I could do is just go into the village and go ahead and break that portal so it doesn't operate anymore. And this should link back with our portal. I'm just going to give it a shot on camera to see if it really does end up with doing that. But it's hard to say, really. Let's go ahead and break this portal. And I'll come back and finish it once I am off camera. And then if we were to just take our elytra and fly over to our base area, I think we might be able to do something with this as well. I can go ahead and pre-make the pockets, put the nether portal on top, put like a trap door so I can parkour out of the 2-block radius, so we can avoid minecarts all in a snap while we are at this stage of the farm. Let me go ahead and give this a shot here. So if we were to enter this portal, it should enter the portal that we were coming out of for the village, so that we can have access to our villagers. Excellent. Excellent. That's what I'm looking for. I don't know exactly where this goes, but I'm just going to break this. Don't need this anymore. So let's go ahead and take that out, and I'll gather obsidian off camera, getting all that stuff prepped up. And I want to try a little trick, and I think I'm going to go ahead and prepare for that, which I need some obsidian. So what a better time to go ahead and break these portals and get our obsidian back. Theoretically, this should work, but I'm not absolutely sure if it's going to. I'm going to go ahead and see. Do I have, yeah, I have a bunch of obsidian here. So the idea is we're going to have boats to be transported into pockets, which I had decided to do like three. So three villagers, three pairs of villagers. So let's go ahead and try this here. So if we'll, I don't know, I put the block there. I have blocks on the side of it already. But let's go ahead and do that. And if this works, this is going to make my life so much easier. And it's going to feel so good to be able to get those villagers back without a hassle. Not have to do all of the minecart stuff. Because I could just put the villagers in there and then, you know, have the boat and break it. Don't have to worry about it anymore. But let's go ahead and give this a shot. I want to see if it at least leads back to where the villagers are. Go ahead and do that. I have broke all the other nether portals, so I'm hoping this works. Please work. Please. Oh, please. It's going to be so much easier. Yes. 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 My life is complete. Oh, that's so much easier. So we can just bring them out on that platform and then roll them out to the glass. So, I guess I need to put in the glass first and probably do an extra layer so that we can easily traverse to those pockets with the villagers themselves. And here's a test villager, which we're going to go ahead and put in this boat right here. And I have to go around the portal, which is a little bit shaky, but we'll go ahead and push him over here into this boat. Drive the boat over to where the other villager is. It's a rather simple process. I had to go ahead and put up a wall to keep them from falling when I do break them from the boat, because unfortunately they cannot fall down a 1x2 area. So let me go ahead and jump out of this boat, hopefully not falling into the actual farm itself. Let's go ahead and break this and make sure there's no blocks that he can fall out of. Let's go ahead and drive him over. And now we just break the boat and do this. And he should almost pop right down there, but we just push him down. There we are. And that's our two villagers for that one. I'll probably have to come back up here and trade with them a bit. Of course, these villagers, like a couple of them don't trade. And I don't know exactly how that works. If they just, you know, start breeding from the door placement or not. But let's go ahead and break the rest of this netherrack and know that we have two villagers there that are safe and ready to go. And I'm thinking of what I could do as far as the outer wall. I'd probably just leave the window here as like a little design, some little knickknack for seeing the villagers. So I think it looks pretty good. I mean, that was a relatively simple process. Last but not least, we have the last villager. Just got to get over here without falling into that pit, because that'd be very bad. Let's go ahead and roll over this single block hole here. Take our pickaxe, hit the corner of that, and push him in. Get over here without falling in myself. And there we are, people. We have ourselves, the villagers, inside of the actual holes now, so that's great. Go ahead and break this, and that should be pretty much everything as far as the villagers go. I may have to actually come back and try to trade with some. I tried to pair them up so that one of them could be traded with and we could probably get some breeding going, because I'm thinking that by trading with them, the breeding process goes a little bit faster. So I think maybe even one of them, if one of them is bred with or actually traded with, then they'll still produce. So I tried to pair them up a little bit. It worked out good. Let's go ahead and break these blocks. Don't care where they go as long as they're just not up here. And we can get the end portal, or not the end portal, but the nether portal off of this platform and take the platform down. And then we need to go ahead and put up our doors, which is going to be the main process for getting these villagers to spawn. Also, I'm thinking about doing one more platform, but I'm not absolutely sure because I don't want it to be too big. And I think maybe this could be one of the right sizes for an iron farm. I don't think it needs to be much bigger than this, because that's a pretty large iron farm. Or even just a single layer. But it depends. If I feel like it, of course I'd fall in here at the last minute. But can we clutch it? No, fortunately not. Oop. Okay. So from here, I'm just going to break down the platform, try to get the doors in, and then maybe even do another layer, depending on what time it is and how much time I've got left. Even though it's a little bit rainy inside, you know, the water, we're going to fix that eventually. I just haven't gotten around to actually putting in the ceiling yet. But we are safe in here, I think. I have laid down some of these flames, which I think will be okay. And don't worry, it's not going to burn. We don't have fire tick on. So let's go ahead and get this done because, wow, I have I've been working on this for quite some time. I've been putting a little bit too much time into this project, but let's go ahead and run our redstone back like this. And I think I had a redstone down here. I was trying to test out a couple of different clocks, and I think I just want to go with this one, just a very basic one. And not optimize at all, really. There's not a lot of optimization to our compactness. I need to really remove that staircase very soon because it's kind of looking blotchy there, but let's go ahead and put our redstone there, and I think that should be a pretty good clock there. And I think maybe that has to be in a subtract mode, but if we were to put just like three pieces in there, would that dispense it? Yeah, okay, so. Working mechanism here. We have this so that whenever the actual golems come down into our lava blade, which we'll be implementing very soon, I just haven't gotten to it yet, we are going to get those items into our hopper system, and they're going to go into this dispenser, and I had planned on using this as like an AFK room. So when it is dispensed, this will go into another hopper down here, which I'm going to be removing this glass to make it look a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. It's going to go into a hopper, into our storage system that's going to be probably to like right here. Probably just a few double chests. We don't need a whole lot. So over here, I have already implemented somewhat of a design for a chest system, but I've just got to work with it. I think maybe even this whole room may need some attention, but now we don't, at least don't have mobs spawning in here, except over there in the staircases we might, but that looks kind of crazy if you ask me. I can't wait to block all that up and get that rain from stopping actual water falling down, which I still got to put in the lava blade. And I think that's about it. If we were to just go outside real quick, which I think I may have some rockets do this before the creeper gets me. Creeper's already blown up half of my base there, if you didn't see that. But if we were to go up here, this is the finished product. Pretty much. That's what's going on. And I was going to check on the villagers anyway and see if they have got to breeding yet. I think you may actually have to trade with them, but I may try to trade with them off camera. I'm hoping I didn't do all of that for nothing, because I'm hoping you don't have to have two trading villagers, or you have to have at least one farmer or something. I don't mind to have like the blacksmiths and things, because I have a bunch of coal. As you can see, I have 14 blocks of coal that we can use to trade with them. But everything, oh my gosh, there's so many mobs around here. I think I'm just going to, what? Okay. I think I'm just going to fly back to base and call it a night, because wow, we have done a lot of work, and I'm thinking that's going to probably finish off the episode for us. I'll get the lava blade in off camera and everything should be good. But thanks for watching, guys. Hope you did enjoy the episode. We will be seeing you in episode 14. We have gotten pretty far, especially needed an iron farm really bad, and I'm glad we started work on that. But you guys have a fantastic day, and we'll see you in the video later down the road. See you later.